Everybody, it's Eric Johnson from Arete Throws Nation, and in this video, we're gonna talk about safety. Now, this is something we talk about and we teach at every camp that we do, and safety is important because even at the highest levels, accidents happen. These mistakes, safety, any devastating kind of accident, and that's unfortunately what can happen with these sports. Now, thankfully, in here in my club, we've been coaching for years. We never have had an incident. We've had maybe somebody like a discus wasn't paying attention, kind of skipped on the ground, maybe one or two instances in about the last 9 years, and that's the way we intend to keep it because we apply the following rules. I was at a U.S. Championships years ago. Unfortunately, I saw an official used to being at marking the events, was at a junior nationals and got a shot put in the head, and he died on site. We had been at a pro meet a couple years ago, saw an official get hit with a javelin. I've seen weird things where young meets where the discus kind of went over and hit somebody in the head. These things do happen and they're accidents, and the point of this video is to cover that and make sure that you never have this happen and be very stern. I'm not light on this. I make my athletes understand it's not a joke. There's no room for error. I've seen this with college age athletes that I've coached, and I've seen this with youth athletes. And once we make this point pretty clear, they're pretty focused and we never have any problem. Here's the simple rule. The thrower is in the circle. Here's what you want to make sure that the thrower, when they step in to throw, they are always saying the magic words, heads up, nice and loud. So anybody who's in the sector getting their implement, whether that's the shot or the discus, hears them, gives them eye contact, and they know they're acknowledged and they're engaged. So therefore, the person out there is aware and this person is aware of who's out there. Oftentimes you'll get a thrower in, they're getting ready to throw, and somebody's picking up an implement and they're not paying attention, which is rule number two. The person in the sector is never to take their eyes off of the throwing circle, ever. So that means if I'm here and you right now watching me are in the circle and I'm picking up my implements, I'm walking like this, keeping my eye on the throwing area, and I'm picking up my implements with my eyes on the circle and on the throwers. That is the rule for when they leave the ring and they're in the sector. The other issue is go on the perimeters. Throwers should be retrieving their implements on the perimeters outside of the sector. Avoid the walking through straight out in the sector. That's no good. You always walk around. They get their implements, walk around, and come back. Follow those simple rules. You should have zero problems. As a coach, you're gonna constantly be aware of who's in the circle and just paying attention. When I train my assistant coaches, that's one of the things I have to explain. You would think when you have college age or post-collegiate, or most of your post-collegiates by this time, they've been pretty well versed. They've been around the sport long enough. They kind of know it's ingrained never to take their eyes off the circle. So again, if you follow those simple rules on safety, we're not gonna have any issues. That's the whole point. We wanna have nice long throwing careers, and that is the key. It's a real simple checklist. Again, thrower in the circle always checks out. Make sure the individuals retrieving implements understand that they're about to throw. The people in the sector are always paying attention and never taking their eyes off the circle. Number three, always walk and get the implements on the perimeter and come back. Number four, coaches are always aware of everybody. And again, that's something I would definitely say happens all the time. I'm always telling kids, pay attention, don't turn your back. You gotta train your athletes to do it. Okay, thanks so much, guys, and we'll see you in the next video. Hey everybody, welcome back. It's Coach Johnson. In this video, we're going to talk about some simple concepts that are going to help you better understand the throw and some of our objectives. Now,